Hi, today we'll discuss understanding double entry systems and types of accounts and recognizing types of accounts. So double entry system is a most scientific, complete and perfect system of bookkeeping. According to this system, every business transaction involves two accounts, one receiving the benefit and the others giving the benefit. The party receiving the benefit is called receivers. The party giving the benefit is called the giver. The one who receives the benefits becomes indebted to the others. The one which gives the benefit gets credit of having given the benefit. Thus, a business transaction affects two accounts in opposite directions. To record the transaction, therefore, one account must be debited and another account has to be credited simultaneously with the same account. So it seeks to record the every transactions in its double aspects. The one aspect is a receiver and the other is a giver. The amount of receivers is a debited and the other that of the giver is a credited. Now, you have to understand the accounts. An account is a summarized record of all the business transactions relating to a particular person, things, and items. An account is a ledger record in the summarized form of all business transactions that have been taken place with the particular persons or things are specified. For example, RAM account, machinery account, wages account, interest accounts. Thus, all transactions enter into with RAM will be recorded in the accounts of RAM. All accounts are divided into two sides. The left side of an account is called debit side, and the right side is called credit side. So here we will discuss the types of accountings. So here is a types of account. Basically it is divided into two parts, personal account and impersonal account. And impersonal account subdivided into two parts, real account and nominal accounts. So let's discuss one by one here. First, personal accounts. Personal accounts are accounts of persons, firms, or companies, such as Rajiv account, account of Fancy Vastralay, account of Das and Brothers, accounts of Bihar Iron and Steel, and bank account, etc. The classification of personal accounts, it be divided into three. First one is a natural account. Natural personal accounts means the account of the actual persons, means the account of human beings. For example, Sanjay account, Sita accounts. Another one is artificial personal accounts. This account has no physical existence as human being, but it work as a personal account. For example, a company is treated as artificial person. So company account is an artificial person. And third one is representative personal accounts, where an account indirectly represent a person or persons. It is said to be a representative personal account. For example, outstanding wages accounts, salary accounts, accrued interest accounts. Now see the here, impersonal accounts is divided into two. So first one say the real accounts. So first, impersonal accounts other than persons accounts are referred as impersonal accounts. Impersonal accounts, as I said, consist of two, real and nominal accounts. So real account are accounts of property, assets, things. For example, cash accounts, land and building accounts, stock accounts, machinery accounts, goodwill accounts. So here, real account also subdivided into two parts, tangible accounts and intangible accounts. Tangible accounts, these accounts are accounts which accounts of such as which can be touched, felt, measured, bought and sold, such as cash account, machinery accounts, etc. Then intangible accounts are accounts of such things which can't be seen, touched in a physical sense, but can be felt and bought and sold. For example, goodwill, patent and copyrights. Now here is the nominal accounts. Nominal accounts means accounts of income, expenses, gain and losses are called nominal accounts. These accounts are called nominal accounts as they exist only in name. They can't be seen or touched. They are simply used to define the nature of transaction. So example of nominal accounts relating to expenses like wages paid, salary paid, rent paid, bad debt, discount allowed, etc. And example of nominal accounts relating to revenues and incomes, interest received, commission received, discount received, etc. Also, here it should be noted clearly that if any word as a prefix or as suffix is added to a nominal account, then it becomes a personal account. Such as, see here, under nominal accounts, salary is a nominal account, but salary, outstanding salary, prepared salary, salary paid in advance, these becomes the personal accounts because of adding prefix or suffix in personal accounts. See second one, interest accounts. It's also the nominal accounts, but when you are adding prefix and suffix like outstanding interest, prepared interest, accrued interest, then it will become the personal accounts. Now see the third one, insurance accounts. Same here, if you use the prefix and suffix, then it will become the personal accounts, like prepared insurance, unexpired insurance, insurance outstanding. Now see here, I am taking one example. Classify the following accounts into personal, real and nominal accounts. Here is a list of accounts. See the list of accounts. And also please here note that I denoted some P for the personal accounts, RP for representative personal accounts, and R for real account, N for nominal account, for saving the times and our convenience. So see here, the first one is a cash accounts. Cash is a current asset of the business, so it's related to the real accounts. So write here R. Write the pen. R means real accounts. See here, bank account. Bank is also the assets of the business, but bank indicate the artificial persons, so it's the personal accounts. Now capital accounts, it's related to also the personal accounts. See the stock accounts. Stock is also the current assets of the business, so it's the real accounts. Now see the drawing accounts. Drawing also is a personal accounts. Now see the outstanding rent. accounts. As I told you, this rent account is a nominal account, but when you prefix any words before the nominal accounts, it will be the personal accounts. So write here P. So this is a personal account, but it's the representative personal account. So write here R, RP. Now accrued interest accounts. It's also the RP. This is a representative personal accounts. Now see the discounts. Discount is nominal accounts, because we are company is giving the discounts to the customer, so it is a nominal accounts. So write here N. Now bank loan accounts. Bank loan accounts is a liability of the business, but it's indicating the bank, so it will be the personal accounts. Here goods account. Goods is also the current asset of the business, so it will be the real accounts. Now tractor account. Tractor is also the asset of the business, so it's also the real accounts. Now goodwill account. Goodwill is an intangible asset of the business. So write here real account, but it's a intangible assets. Now furniture. Furniture fixed assets of the business, so write here real account. Then plant and machinery accounts is also the real accounts. Bad debt account, it's the expenses of the business, so that means it's not expenses, it's the losses of the business, because bad debt is the amount that the customer is unable to the pay to the company. So write here nominal account. Investment accounts. Investment account is also the real account, because it's the financial assets. Now see the prepaid insurance accounts. So it's also the RP, that means representative personal accounts. Now depreciation is also the expenses, so it's a nominal account. Right here N. Now printing and stationery accounts is also expenses. Sorry, printing and stationery expense. It's not expensive. It's a property of the assets of the business. So it's a real account. R. Land and building. It's also the assets of the business. So write here real accounts. Anil accounts is indicating the personal accounts. P. So here is how you identified whether you have to recognize how you will can require. First you understand what is related to expense, what is the expense. If it is expense, then it will be the nominal account. If it is a property or assets, then it will be the real accounts. It's related to the persons, that means natural persons, so then it will be the personal accounts. So I think you understand the and recognize how you can recognize the accounts in that way. You have to find the related accounts and name of the accounts or the types of accounts. So here give the name of the accounts, personal, real and nominal account in the following transactions. So see here, they started business on 1st January, started business with cash rupees 10,000. So amount you can leave like, you know, first you have to understand which types of accounts in that transactions. So see here is your first is a cash accounts, another is a capital accounts, because the cash is coming in business as a proprietor capital, so creditor will be capital account. So cash will be the real account and capital will be the personal accounts. Now see the fifth on fifth deposit into bank accounts. When deposit into bank, there is two transaction here, two accounts, bank account and another is a cash account. Another is cash accounts. So bank is a personal accounts because it is the institutions. That's why it's the personal accounts. So right here personal accounts and cash is a real accounts. Now see another transaction, bought goods for cash. So here is a two accounts. Purchase accounts and cash accounts. So it will be purchase is also real accounts and cash is also real accounts. Both account is a real accounts. Now see on 5th January, sold goods for cash rupees 5000. So leave the amounts and see here sold goods. That means cash is coming. Cash, there is two accounts. First one is a cash and another is a purchase or goods accounts. So both account is a real account here. You can classify. Now on 20th, sold goods to Gopal. So you sold goods to Gopals means here is one Gopal account and another is goods accounts. So Gopal is a personal account, a goods is a real account. Now see another one, received cash from Gopal, but actual they need to pay 2000, but he paid 1980, and that means 20 is a discount. So right here there is a three accounts. First cash accounts, then discount, then Gopal. So first is a real account, this is a nominal account, and this is a personal accounts. Now see last one. See here on 31st January, first one is a paid rent, then paid salary. So here is a on January 31st rent account, cash account and salary accounts. You can also put this salary offer and cash below. So see here, rent is a nominal account, cash is a real account and salary is a nominal accounts. And like that you can understand the types of accounts and recognize the all the accounts for better understandings. So that you can understand the general, how to generalize the entry easily. So next video will be the how to golden rules of the accountings. That means the rules of debit and credit. Please subscribe my channels for more video and updates. Thank you.